Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamswari.com. In the last video, we discussed about the first line of defense. In this video, we are going to discuss the second line of defense within 10 minutes. Second line of defense is the innate form of non-specific defense mechanism that removes pathogen entered into the body by means of defensive cells, proteins, and other responses like fever and inflammation. When the pathogen has crossed the first line of defense, second line of defense comes into play. First, let's have a quick summary of second line of defense. The defensive cells involved in second line of defense are macrophages, neutrophils, and dendritic cells. That these three forms the professional phagocytes. Then there is natural killer cells, and then mast cells, eosinophils, and basophils. These three mediates allergic responses. The proteins involved are interferons, antimicrobial peptides, ion-binding proteins, and complement system. Other coordinated responses include inflammation and associated fever to remove pathogen from the system. Let's move into the detail. Defensive cells in second line of defense. The first three, macrophages, neutrophil, and dendritic cells, they are called the professional phagocytes. How these cells recognize the pathogen? So this is a macrophage. So as you can see, on the surface, there are receptors that can recognize pathogenic particles. These receptors are called pattern recognition receptors, and these pathogenic particles are called pathogen-associated molecular patterns. One of the classical examples of pattern recognition receptor is toll-like receptor. So this receptor recognizes lipopeptide particle of a pathogen, flagellin, the protein that makes flagella of the pathogen, and also the peptidoglycan, the cell wall of pathogen. The components of pathogen is recognized by these receptors, pattern recognition receptors. After recognition, the next thing is phagocytosis. This pathogen is engulfed and that is coated by a vesicle, then it is called as a phagosome. Then lysosome inside the macrophage fuses with this phagosome, forming phagolysosome. Lysosome, as we know, it contains acids, digestive enzymes that digest the pathogen completely or destroys the pathogen completely, and the residual bodies or the undigested matter is removed by exocytosis, thus completely destroying the pathogen. This is how professional phagocytes like macrophages, neutrophils, and dendritic cells works. So these are the first type of defensive cells that reaches the site of infection. Next cell is the natural killer cell. Natural killer cell is very efficient in destroying viral infected cells and tumor cells. So as you can see, these viral infected cells, there will be some receptors or stress signals are produced by such type of cells as some chemicals or maybe forming a pathogenic peptide or pathogenic patterns on the receptor that is attracted by these NK cells. NK cells binds to such cells and it can destroy that cells by means of creating pores on the membrane, by means of perforins that creates pores on the membrane, then granzyme, a digestive enzyme that degrades the ender cell, killing the infected cell completely. Then it can destroy virus-infected macrophages also. They secrete certain chemical messengers like interleukin-12 or maybe on the receptor that can activate this natural killer cell. Ultimately, it secretes interferons and finally killing macrophages completely. Then the next three cells, mast cells, basophils, and eosinophils, all mediates allergic reactions and inflammatory responses. These are all having almost same receptors, but they are in different locations. For example, mast cells are tissue resident cells that is involved in immediate hypersensitivity, whereas basophils are cells that are circulating cells that is involved in late phase response or mediating allergic reactions in late phase response, whereas eosinophils are present on gastrointestinal tract. All mediates allergic reactions and inflammation. They are involved in immune surveillance. These cells are very effective against parasitic infections. Let's take one example. As you can see, this mast cell is having a receptor for IgE that mediates allergic reactions. Then there are many granules inside. All these granules contains chemical messengers like histamine, nitric oxide, tryptase, etc. All can activate other cells and induce inflammatory response. So all these cells, upon activation, there will be degranulation or release of chemical messengers that activates altogether all other types of immune cells, ultimately leading to inflammatory response, thus removing the pathogen from the system. Now moving into the proteins in second line of defense. The most important protein is undoubtedly the interferons. How interferon works? As you can see, this is a virus infected cell. Virus, once inside the cell, it replicates, then viral proteins are synthesized, that is assembled, and virus will be released to the outside. During that process, the infected cell synthesizes interferons. This interferon will be released and there will be interferon receptors on the neighboring cells. So neighboring cells receive this interferon and get ready to destroy the virus. Interferons are just like an alert signal that protects the neighboring cells or that informs the neighboring cells about the virus infection. What is actually happening is, upon the activation of this interferon receptor by interferons secreted by the neighboring cell, the cell starts synthesizing RNases and proteases. So RNases will cleave the viral genome and proteases cleaves the viral proteins, preventing its replication inside the uninfected cell or the neighboring cell, thus protecting the neighboring cell from viral infection. The second type of protein involved in second line of defense is antimicrobial peptides or AMPs. Antimicrobial peptides are often positively charged proteins, often amphipathic with a hydrophobic region and hydrophilic region. It can directly bind to the membrane of the pathogen. It is capable of creating pores. It causes rupture of the membrane, or it can enter inside the pathogen and cause and inhibits intracellular function, ultimately causing the lysis of the cell, thus inhibiting the growth of pathogens inside. The other methods include, it can recruit or activate other immune cells like neutrophils and monocytes, thus enhancing phagocytosis, or it is capable of directly neutralizing lipopolysaccharides or pathogenic particles, then it enhances the ability of immune cells to recognize this viral genome, that is viral RNA or DNA, thus promoting inflammatory responses. Examples include defensins produced by macrophages, dermicidin produced by epithelial cells, maximin, which is present in skin secretions. And the third one is iron binding proteins. And classical example is lactoferrin, which is present in colostrum and also produced by neutrophils. It is actually an antimicrobial protein with iron binding properties. So this protein is capable of removing free iron particles from the circulatory system. Iron is an essential requirement for the growth of bacteria, thus inhibiting the growth of bacteria. Other example is transferrin. Iron binding protein is actually an antimicrobial peptide with iron binding capacity. And the fourth one is complement system. Complement system includes set of plasma proteins that is involved in defense mechanism that enhances phagocytosis or killing of pathogen by means of a membrane attacking complex. So many proteins are involved. It may be, this is the classical pathway, a pathogen that is bounded by an antibody. This Fc region can activate this complement system, the C1 protein of complement system. Then there is a cascade, that is, this will activate C2 and C4b. Then further down, it activates many different types of proteases, ultimately forming a membrane attacking complex that either enhances the phagocytosis capacity of professional phagocytes, or it can directly kill the pathogen, creating pores on the membrane and causing lysis of the pathogen. And this is the alternative pathway where pathogenic particles can directly activate this complement proteins, ultimately leading to the formation of MAC or membrane attacking complex that perforates the membrane and causing lysis of the pathogen. Now the final, other coordinated responses, that includes fever and inflammation. When there is an injury, what happens is there will be increased blood flow causing redness, then there will be a heat that is followed by pain. These are the cardinal signs of inflammation. What is actually happening is, when there is an injury, many chemicals are secreted like histamines, prostaglandins, all causes capillary widening, resulting in increased blood flow, that is the reason for red color, followed by swelling because of the fluid along with immune cells. Then pyrogens are produced that increases the temperature. This fever inhibits the growth of pathogens inside the body, inside the system as a whole. Then tissue damage causes pain. All these coordinated responses ultimately aims at preventing pathogen from further entry into the system. And these are the cardinal signs of inflammatory reaction: heat, redness, swelling, and pain. So this is actually happening. Many professional phagocytes are there, macrophages are there, mast cells that is involved in inflammatory responses, the neutrophils will be there. Many chemical signals, cytokines, histamines will be released that alert the entire immune system to the site, especially non-specific defense system to the site, and that will continuously phagocytose and remove pathogens from the system. Dead cells along with dead tissues will be removed as pus, and the battle goes on till the tissue is completely healed. And these are the mechanisms by which our second line of defense works. If you find this video useful, please consider subscribing our channel. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com.